St. Lucia is charging forward into the future of sustainable transportation with the revolutionary Nissan e-Power. Unveiled at the recent EV Expo hosted by the Ministry of Sustainable Development, this cutting-edge system offers a glimpse into a cleaner, more efficient driving experience.
Internal combustion engine is an engine that consists of an engine, a transmission, and the drivetrain, which means the axles and the tires. A hybrid vehicle would consist of an internal combustion engine, a electric motor that assists the normal conventional transmission, and it also consists of a battery or an inverter and a source to store the power, which would be the battery. A electric vehicle consists of a battery and the electric motor that drives the wheels. That's the basic components. E-Power consists of an internal combustion engine, an electric motor, battery for storage of power, and an inverter.
With its unique configuration, E-Power eliminates direct engine-to-wheel connections, streamlining energy conversion and ensuring maximum efficiency. This breakthrough design sets it apart from both traditional hybrids and fully electric vehicles.
I'd love to purchase a fully electric vehicle, however, the dealerships we have in St. Lucia did not give me that option. And the closest option to fully electric was that of the E-Power from Nissan. So hence the reason I opt to go with the E-Power rather than that of the Toyota RAV4, which were in the same class of vehicles when I was in the market to buy one.
By eliminating direct engine-to-wheel connections, E-Power reduces energy consumption, creating a more efficient and simplified drivetrain compared to conventional hybrids. This system significantly impacts fuel efficiency.
A lot of persons talk about the tank capacity. So they come with a 55-liter tank. And on average, we look at about, we've seen vehicles give as low as 650, 700 km per tank, and they go as high as 950 to 1,000.
I move from purchasing fuel every week to once a month, which means that I pretty much save half of what I used to save when I owned a fully ICE vehicle.
Naturally, with advancements in technology comes the demand for qualified personnel for servicing and maintenance requirements.
With our vehicles, the E-Power, we have a set of technicians and staff that are well capable of handling these vehicles. And when I say well capable, technology and information evolves, in essence, every day. So one of the things that we do via our Nissan platform, it's called the Virtual Academy, we are always updated as to the latest technology and training that Nissan offers, especially when it comes to these new vehicles. So we have this platform that every one of our technicians are exposed to, and not just our technicians, the service advisors, the supervisors, myself. And we are held accountable by Nissan as to our progress. So for example, if I were to lapse on my training, then I get an email telling me, hey, you have not yet completed 1, 2, 3, 4. You have a deadline of 1, 2, 3, 4 to complete these. Because what they try to do is to ensure that we stay on top of the latest information, the latest, you know, technology.
The E-Power vehicle benefits from lower import duties and excise taxes compared to non-E-Power models.